because there's no waistline seam on this design, it's going to be faster to start from a basic princess pattern. You probably have a blouse pattern that you can start from. If not, you can ask me. This is identical in appearance to the one that we use in beginning pattern making that's half scale. So even though I'm using the computer, I won't be explaining how to use the computer, just how to make a design. So I need to start by moving this dart into the shoulder. No, wait, I'm leaving that one there, and that one's in the right place too. So I'm going to turn this part into two separate princess lines, and I'm going to draw my design lines on it so that it can cut away. In order for there to be a button in the middle right here, it has to extend past, otherwise they'll just touch in the middle. So I'm going to extend this out 5/8 of an inch, or half scale, that would be 5/16 of an inch. I have the pattern arranged so I've got my front side seam next to my back side seam, so I can see how the design lines are going to relate to each other. And I have that offset line, so right here is my center front, and this is my fold line. So this is where the button is going to be placed, would be right here. So I'm going to swap those two lines. Right here is where that button is going to be. So it will be right on the center front, and then there will be space for it to overlap when it buttons. I've drawn a line from the top of my armhole dart to the bust point, and now I'm going to move the end of this dart over to line up with that so it's easier for me to make my princess line. So I have my princess line curve drawn, and they're sharing the edge right here for both sides, and I will end up getting rid of this space and turning it into seam allowance. And now I need to decide where I want my lapel and my shawl collar to be. So I want my shawl collar, based on the picture, it's ending down here, just almost right at the button. I'm going to start it slightly at the top, and it looked like it was about this wide in the picture. You can certainly make that narrower or wider. So that's how wide the lapel is going to be. I also need to change the neckline because it has a lower neckline. So I'm going to bring that line over until it touches the curve right there. Maybe I need to move that back a little bit. So I'm going to join that right there at the edge of the neck. So this line is going to curve around, and then this part is going to be gone. And that's my design plan right there. And you can make them wider or narrower, longer, shorter. Those are all design choices. I may make this more curved later on. to see the drawing again. It makes it easier. I also want to put the side seams closer together. This line is coming from the center front over to the side seam. And before you put that design line on here, you're going to want to lengthen your paper if you want the coat longer. I'm going to go ahead and keep it the length that it is, but you can lengthen or shorten it and do the same thing. Although, if I lengthen it, it's going to be easier to make this look more pointy. So, I'll change my mind and I'm going to lengthen the coat a little bit longer. Alright, I've moved these two pieces so that the side seams are touching. In this case, the underarm also almost touches, but depending on the size of the pattern or person you're working on, you can only put them as close together as the side seam down here. You could also think about adding some flare. This looks like maybe there is flare added to the side seam on it, but I think we're trying to make this look like it's one piece, the way these two come together, and it's going to look nicer if we use this side seam and take this out because it will be more fitted. So I'm going to leave that fitting in there, and these are going to be sewn together on the side seam, but they're going to look and function as one piece even though there's a seam there. I'm going to make the design line look like it's one piece. So as I'm looking at the front, my front, I'm going to come just a little bit below that. Maybe I should move that line down so it comes to an exact point right there. Okay, I'll do that. I'm just going to move this one up. Okay, so that's going to come to an exact point. I'm going to come over to the side seam and draw a curved line right there. And I think, I mean, I could put this line anywhere I want it, but based on the design, I want it a little bit curved down here at the bottom. So maybe I have lengthened this too much. This line is okay, but if I come up and shorten it a little bit, how is that going to... So that's giving me more the shape I want for that line. So depending on where you start this line, I think that's a little shorter than it, it isn't as pointy down here as I want it. So play with that, get the line length that you want. I'm going to go with the shorter one. And now I want to end in the same place on the side seam as this line so that they come to a point together. And if I'm looking right here, this is coming back up and joining with the bottom of that dart. So I'm going to join with the bottom of the dart, and I've kind of got a mirror image right here. You're going to be seeing it most from the front view, and that's going to make it very pointy. And then, well, I like the way that's connected. you see. Then this part of the line I want to come straight over from and blend that curve right there so that they join most of the way down. And I want to keep this as a right angle coming into there. So I'm going to specifically use my ruler and make this a right angle line for a little bit. And then I'm going to blend it with another right angle right here. So it doesn't need to be a right angle for a long time, but I want it to be a nice smooth curve. So I'm being careful about my right angles. Okay. Once I'm happy with the design lines that I've got on there, then I can start to trace off my pieces. So I'm going to separate this into a piece and this into a piece, and I'm going to leave out the dart and not include it in my pieces. And I'll move this one so that this is a piece and this is a piece. And because this seam line is here and it's just going to join right there, if you press it well and don't and use the kind of some kind of fabrics will show more than others, but you won't really see that line so much as you will the design line around it when it's all sewn together. All right, I have taken off this piece because it's the shape of my neckline, so my neckline doesn't come out here anymore, and this is my center front princess. I'm not including the darts because they have been converted to seams now, so I have this piece and this piece, and they are going to sew together so that those lines disappear and this line is nice and smooth. I'm going to move that out of the way for a minute. Traced off the side back, leaving this little gap right here. And this could be longer. I mean, I may have missed that design line. It looks like to me that maybe this line should be a little bit longer than it is. But I have my side pieces, and these two are going to sew together right there and create a point. And then this one is going to sew to this one. It would be a good idea if you put a notch somewhere here and a couple of notches somewhere here so you know where to stop sewing them together and this becomes a gap. But in order for this to work and have separate pieces, you're going to have to cut the back out of your fashion fabric on the fold, and then you're going to have to cut a lining piece out of lining fabric on the fold, and the same with all of the rest of them, so that when you have these two pieces sewn together, and these two pieces sewn together, and you've got your body fabric and your lining fabric, you can sew all of the pieces together and finish them on the inside and stop sewing right here and leave this part open and not sewn, so that when you finish it, you're going to put the lining against this piece and just sew this one separate and this one separate with its lining. And then it will join the body so that the inside will be all lined, but there will be a gap right here. And because it's lined, you can fold the lining in here and you can fold the lining in here. But in the rest of it, it covers the inside so that your point is created and your separation between those two pieces is created. And we can move that line down to wherever we want it with our pencil or our computer, but make it as long as you want. And if you decided that you wanted more flair on this piece, then you can extend this line further out. But when you do that, you would also need to extend this line further out the same amount so that they stay balanced, but they can both be more flared. You just add the same amount to both sides. And I didn't. I added a slightly different amount to both sides, but you'll have your ruler and you'll be able to measure it and start from the same level on both pieces and measure out the same amount on both pieces and draw the line between the two. I've rearranged the pieces so that I have my two back pieces together at the shoulder right here, and then I've lined up my front piece with the shoulder. So this is where my collar is and this is where the button is, and they're all aligned on the collar, I mean to make the collar, and they're aligned on the shoulder seam. So make sure you redraw this line so you get a perfectly straight line between your two back pieces where I've got that dotted line. I had to fix it a little bit, and make sure that your front is aligned, your front neck is aligned to your back neck at the shoulder corner. It's really easy when you're working with paper or the computer to accidentally flip them over and get your front neck going into your back armhole. So don't do that. Make sure it's back neck to front neck, back armhole to front armhole. And then if you're going to create a shawl collar that's laying flat, then I've overlapped this a half an inch so I could measure the same width and create the rest of my collar. I want it the same width, and I'm just going to guess, but you can measure. And then I would join that line and create the curve that I want for my collar, and that's going to become all one piece. And I think I need to move that down. Make sure you have a right angle happening there in the back. Have a right angle there, measure it with your ruler, and then I could trace that piece off and that would be my shawl collar. If I want my collar to stand and roll on top of itself and then get wider at the shoulder, then I would need to make this space right here long enough that it could come up and fold back down and cover itself and end at the edge right here. So I'm talking about, if this is my neckline edge and I want my collar to come up the back of the neck and come back down and end overlapping the bottom, that edge a little bit, then this is going to have to join and blend with that to fall that way. And maybe that doesn't make sense, so we'll look at the drawing for a minute. If this collar, instead of being, and I probably should have drawn that a little bit lower, so that this width is the same as that width right there. If I want it to lay kind of flat like that, then I've aligned it already the way it should be. But if I want a collar that comes, that starts at the neckline edge and climbs up the neck and stays there and then comes down so that the collar is arching up and over and then blending in, then I would want a straighter collar on that line. I wouldn't want it so this would blend and kind of go up the back neck and come down. And either one is going to work. It's just going to be a different amount that you overlap this piece onto this one. So if I were do it, if you want it to just lay flat, just trace this piece off as a collar. So I'll do that before I move on to the next option. Okay, so this piece just got traced off of there, and that is your shawl collar. And you would cut this part on the fold. You can separate it and change the grain, but you can also cut it on the fold. And you'd want to put a notch right here where it lines up with the shoulder seam. And you would cut four of those, or you would cut two and then cut an under collar that was narrower, like we've talked about in class. But if instead of having a collar that lays flat against the body, if I want it to roll up and back, then instead of following the shape of this line, I would measure this line. And that's a really odd color, but that's this line is 3 1/16 long. So instead of making it like that, I would use this line and I'd extend. I'd continue this line up. And then at 3 inches, I'd draw a right angle and come back down and blend into this. And you can look up shawl collar in the book for a slightly different explanation, but the straighter the line is, the more it's going to roll. Just like with any other collar, this one you just think about a little bit differently, and we'd just continue the line up the same length that is as the length of the neckline. And then it will still fit and sew in the back, but it will stand up straight. So I measured up here 3.081, and I made a right angle. And then I can join this part of the line into a right angle back here. And that would be my shawl collar instead. So this collar that I just made, I extended the line out straight, made a right angle, and traced that one off. And this collar is the one that's got the straightest line that's going to stand up the highest. If I wanted to do another version, this one will lay down the flattest. And if I want to do one partway in between those two, like that second line I've got drawn there, then I could come in here and right angle off of this line and blend into that one too. So I could make it be here instead. And that line will only partially roll up and back down. And I could trace that one off too. So any of those collars is going to be correct. It's just going to hang differently from one to the next. And you're welcome to ask me about that, but look up shawl collars in the book, and it might be easier for you to understand than that explanation. But all three of those collars will fit on this. They're all a shawl collar. It just has to do with the different amount and whether they lay flat. I explain collars kind of upside down and backwards to the way the book does. And if that one didn't make sense to you, the other one says the same thing. It arrives at the same end, but it puts it in different words. So you would need to choose the one that you were going to use and then make a piece that was smaller, so you had an under collar and a top collar. So your under collar is the smaller one, and it's just an eighth of an inch to a quarter of an inch smaller on the back, and then it blends as it gets around to the front, and that keeps it from showing. Sometimes you'll see an under collar cut on the bias and even a little bit narrower than that, but for half scale you don't need to go there. So that one is supposed to look like that, and if you can get the pattern made and cut out the fashion fabric and the lining fabric, and in this case for a first test, don't actually use expensive fabric, just use two layers of muslin and sew it together, except right here I've put notches for matching, and right here I put a notch between these two pieces. If you'll put one at the top of where you want that vent to open, when you're sewing all of the pieces, just leave these two sections unsewn, and I will show you how to sew them if you don't understand. And I can show you that in person. Text me quick pictures if you have questions.